which treatment did they prefer?
Okoport has an empty food bank. But Mr. Hini said that when the last time he came, he chose T5 and T8. Okay.
T5 and T8.
Soil fertility decline in the tropics, especially in Ghana, is a great concern. So together with farmers, we are using the organic resource management to improve soil fertility in our environment here. Through this research, together with the farmers, we've realized that application of organic resources improves the water retention capacity of the soil. By using these resources, we are mitigating the release of methane and carbon dioxide, which will have gone to the environment. That will create more greenhouse gases and increase the disasters caused by climate change, and also using it to improve the soil fertility and increasing food production.
When Prof. Budu set in, he taught us how to use the local materials to make the organic fertilizer. I went inside, I saw it was very, very good. An acre of land, I got the yield to be 6 bags of maize. But when Prof. came introducing this one, I got to know that I got 18, 19 or 20. At an acre. So I saw that it's very, very good. Since then, I've never used the inorganic again. I'm always using the organic fertilizer.
So through these projects, we've been able to advise the farmers or create awareness to the farmers about the importance of the empty food bank. That's the residue after removing the nuts from the fresh fruit bunch. And also biochar, which is the carbonation of the rice husks. And they're also using the cocoa pod husks and the empty fruit bunch to prepare compost. Hitherto, all these materials were discarded. They were not being used and of no importance. So through this project, all these organic resources have been made known to the farmers to be very, very important in improving the soil fertility in an environment.
This is biochar. Rice husks in preparing the biochar. We, in burning, we use empty barrel. We pierce through, we put fire inside. Then we sprinkle the rice husks around it. Later, when it gets to this stage, then we put water on it so that it becomes dry.
These materials are very common in our environment, but mainly people don't find the use. So I want to look at the economic importance and also finding suitable ratios of these materials. So economically, the farmers will now save money in adding fertilizer to their field because these are organic sources which add nutrients to the plants. Naturally, it is also environmental friendly, and in terms of moisture retention, is good for the plants.
Mami ho se e boa me san se mi na miniska de to fertilizer na nkasa nti we ni ba na mama ni ji ho nti mi yiri me ho e de ma ho odin e ye kakra mitumi aye boa me bebre nti me ho se mfa so wo so se me kire afoforo so a omo so aye nti no na me gu so a me kire afoforo se we ni ma we ye tugu ye nton man ye wa ha nti we ni ska kra no a o yiri ho na o so kakra de ho de so kakra e be ma wo no bai no aye.
2017, when the National Farmers Association came to my farm, they saw that I was doing very good. They saw the maize there, and they saw that it was very, very good. So I was selected the best regional farmer in Eastern region. I mean, I've taught 15 people how to do it, and they are doing it on their farms.
un projet de recherche pour le développement dont les technologies ont été conçues par les chercheurs et expérimentées par les agriculteurs. On a essayé de faire des parcelles avec glycidia et des parcelles sans glycidia pour voir l'effet direct de la technologie dans les différentes parcelles. Donc c'est pour avoir des technologies pour les producteurs qui permettent de résoudre leurs contraintes et assurer leur sécurité alimentaire.
Pour les années sans année, d'avoir abouti,
avec les différents avantages multiples du glycidia, tels que la fertilité des sols, on sait aussi que tout arbre gère en quelque sorte, contribue à minimiser l'effet de l'érosion. Donc on les a sollicités, ça, ils disent qu'ils vont l'essayer. Donc à travers cet essai, on a essayé d'implanter le glycidia sur la parcelle de 15 paysans.
Ne toi ba musa traoré ka bon ma fa menga girisi ta furo de la ma fa ya sisa girisi ya giri vraiment bin na fa do du ko la agili re ni ya da furo a tru furo la agili ken na fa ba du ko ma ima nyo da koro doro o agili mi se ka na fa ba do du ko mo bon ya furat ke ka da nyo koro doro abi suma sigi nyo koro bo abi nyo barka do nyo na abi du ko fa ga di du ko ma pour ke nyo se ka ta nyefe ko ti nga damna nana ayoro do di damo ko katma amba damne kana danga fara turanga furulo ka turu yoro do dugoro ni zali do ni ya turu yoro do abi na fadde o la ko ka turu ko no ko na damna ni dugulo ni faka bane do ya do la faka do mo ko a damna dugulo faka bane ni la
ni le mafe ne ba atike ni ya ya masin atike ha kili ka abe jade bon le mafe ne ba atike ka adat le la na dara fere di do bore ko no baga
Quand on a essayé d'implanter l'essai, la gestion de la biomasse était comme cela. On coupait la biomasse de glycidia pour la première fois, on l'enfouissait au sol. Pour la deuxième fois, si possible, on l'enfouissait au sol quand on sentait le besoin. Sinon, on gardait cette biomasse séchée et donnée aux animaux pour leur nutrition. Donc voilà en quelque sorte les différents avantages que les paysans ont essayé d'exploiter dans le cadre du projet ORM4Soil.
Je suis là. 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 Ngirum segara ne yadu ro fanna ci na be bar kon di ko
ah ne be segu ne bu la dige e ki kaddu ko lo e ka la pato ni fara fi buray e fara fi no ko ni ka la pato no ka da sara ni ma la pato ki po sara
ni ko tan yato se sa di jangoni ka nyen ni ko do a barara ko se ngato ko jija fa ngani ni ka se a kaddu ko do la ko di ko ngara ko namani ni sengra befe e ka jija ka donon du ko la le na tawra bana fa sara